Extremely long lasting, has a beautiful shade range, but I'm in the shade 7.5. It is a tad bit lighter on me. Buying a foundation, especially for 4,000-5,000 rupees, has to make my skin look like it is made of like a baby's ass, you know. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. So in this video, you've read the title already. This is part 3 of my foundation review slash references slash opinions, different types of things. But I did 2 other parts. I'll leave the links to it. I almost reviewed around 20 foundations before. This just helps, you know, for you to know my foundation shade in a certain foundation or what I think about it. One accumulated video of different reviews that I do. So I have almost 8 to 9 foundations today as well. These are things I recently tried and I love some, I hate some. You can see the swatches of what they look like compared to my original shade, which is MAC NC20. And I actually use the Maybelline Fit Me as a reference for drugstore as well. So yeah, let's get started. Yeah. Most of the products in this video actually are on the luxury sides because lately I've been trying a lot of luxury foundations. So first up, we have the OG, which is the NARS Radiant Longwear Foundation. Now, this one is not a new launch or a new foundation, but I got my hands on it like a year ago, like basically after that video. And I don't really have to say much about it. There is a reason everybody raves about it. The finish is just... It's so beautiful. It just melts into your skin. It gives you such great coverage. It is medium to full coverage. You can have like a very, very skin-like finish. No matter how much you build it, it does not become cakey. It's extremely long-lasting. Has a beautiful shade range. I'm in the shade Aruba. I feel like Aruba is a little neutral for me, but it works great. Once I applied it on the entire face, it doesn't really matter. But if I was given a choice, I would go like one shade here and there, which is a little more yellow for me. Because this I feel like is a little neutral, but honestly you really can't tell. It's just a preference, and I have this, so I'm using this and it works very well for me. And the yellow one, I was like, maybe what if it is again too yellow or too warm? So this worked perfect, and this is what I got. I really give this foundation a 10 on 10. No matter what your skin type is, you can use it dry, oily, combination, anybody. It just works very well. And yeah, I don't have anything bad to say about it. Only one thing is, if you do have like really oily skin, then maybe like a mattifying primer or a powder before the foundation would help. Only if you get like really oily, otherwise it stays up pretty well throughout the day. You can see the shade comparison. This is the MAC NC40, then this is NARS. Next, we have the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. Now, I reviewed this foundation recently only. I will leave a link of it. If you want to see the finish of it, how it works, etc., you can go there. But I'm in the shade 7.5. It is a tad bit lighter on me. But again, overall, if I just put it and blend it, you really can't tell. And there's a shade 7.75 after this. And I feel like maybe that would match me right now currently because I'm a little more tan, especially after Thailand. But I know the tan will wear off soon and it will be like a perfect match. Again, this foundation is a very lightweight, skin-like foundation. This works great if you want like a natural finish in your foundation because a single layer just gives you a beautiful, radiant skin. I don't know what it does. It just gives you, it reflects light so well that it just gives you your skin but better kind of thing. I don't think it's a buildable foundation though. So if you just want like a very medium coverage, sheer to medium coverage foundation which blurs out everything, then it's a great one. Again, so but it works very great. It's a stunning foundation and I absolutely loved it. But it's not a full coverage foundation at all or a full glam, like an extreme heavy glam. I don't think it is for that. But overall, if you use this and then like a concealer, you will have like a full beat face, but definitely not a buildable one. It works again very long lasting. I wore this to a shoot. Again, you go check that video out. I broke down every single thing about that foundation there, like in detail. Next, I have the Maybelline SPF 50 Skin Tint. Now, this one is in the shade 9. So, with Maybelline Fit Me, what happens is, like, you know, the Maybelline Fit Me foundation 310 tends to be a little very, again, tad bit lighter, little neutral on me. But again, 330 seems too warm. So, 332 is my perfect shade there. And the same thing is with this. 9 works well, actually, almost really well. But I feel like it is still not my exact skin tone, but it's a great one. Again, a very everyday, you're running out to office, running anywhere, and you just want to put it. I to literally put it in my hand and just slather it on, a little bit of blush, and it works pretty well. Nothing much to say about it. It's not like it's an exceptional, like, you know, you cannot survive without this. But it's also not like it really doesn't work. It's a very good one. Like, if you want a good, decent, affordable skin tint for an everyday basis, then you can definitely try this. It's a very decent skin tint. Next, we have the PAC Cosmetics Studio HD Liquid Foundation. Now, PAC's foundation actually were one of the widest shade range available foundations. Initially, even when there was no makeup Indian brands in India, this was the one we had like a lot of shades in. And the initial formula was very okay-ish. I found it a bit cakey, but they reformulated it and relaunched it recently. Again, great shade range. And this is in the shade 3.1. It matches me perfectly as well. Now, this one is not a skin-like finish foundation. This is like a full-blown, full glam moment foundation. If you have a wedding to go, a party to go, you want like a good, nice base, long-lasting, full coverage, then this is that foundation for you. You'll feel like it is makeup. It's not like a skin tint, which is like you just put it, it blurs out, and you know, have a little bit of blemishes peeping through, but your skin is also looking nice. It's not that one. It will not work for it. It is like a makeup. It's a foundation, a proper one, which is great for weddings and parties, like I told you. Now, 3.1 is there, but I have another shade which is 3.2 or 3. I just mix a little bit of that in this and then it gives me a perfect shade. But by itself also, you can see it's a very, very close match. I love the undertones of it. I actually have 3-4 shades in this one, and I feel like they ace the undertones and the colors, or the shade range. I feel like it's really nice. It does go until a proper deep shade range, so you can find your shade. Next, I have the MAC Studio Radiance Foundation. This is the serum powered foundation. This is again a very skin like serum like foundation type of thing which MAC launched, and this is amazing. The way it blends on the skin, the way it looks, it's a very, very, again, everyday kind of it. Like, the Studio Fix Fluid of MAC is again one of my OG favorite foundations, but that foundation is also like a makeup product. Like, you put it on, you know that there's makeup on your skin, but it's like that full coverage moment kind of foundation. So they've launched a serum version of it, which just blurs out everything, is your beautiful, beautiful finish. Now, like I told you, I'm MAC NC40, so this also I got in NC40. But the thing with this is that it oxidizes a lot. So if you want to invest in this foundation, I would ask you to go a shade down. I probably would buy shade NC38, so that once it oxidizes, it comes to my shade. Because if once I put this on, it oxidizes and gets too yellow and too warm. My face is one color, my neck is one color. It just really doesn't match, because it oxidizes a lot. But other than that, the finish of it is like, it is so, so pretty. It's a very minimal makeup kind of product compared to the Studio Fix Fluid, which they have. It's like a full glam moment. Next, what do I have? Rare Beauty. Rare Beauty is now available in India. So Rare Beauty I have in the shade 32N. Now, 32N I feel like is definitely very neutral for me. This one actually my sister sent me without me checking my shade range or anything. So she sent something which is way too neutral. So I would go like a shade up and one which is warm. But this one I feel like is a very average skin tint. I would rather recommend at this point, if you want to buy this in India, you get this Studio Radiance MAC in the same price range. So I would rather recommend you buy the MAC one and a shade lighter one, because of course that oxidizes. But this one is a very not a big fan. It's okay. I don't reach out to this as often. It does not impress me in a wow factor. So if you have it, it's great. You can use it for like an everyday thing, but it's nothing like super duper wow, it makes my skin look like I've never seen this before kind of thing, or it's not very like beautifully blurring or anything. It's very okay-ish. Like, very 50-50 about it. So I would recommend the MAC instead of the Rare Beauty. Now, the next foundation, man, I spent so much on this foundation and it was such a disappointment because I had such high expectations on this. So next one I have is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Foundation. I have the shade Warm Sand 8. Now, this foundation, I heard, oh my god, so much about it, guys. I love the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder. It's my ride or die. If I don't have it, I can't breathe. It's really like my favorite powder. The blushes are great. Everything else is great. So I thought like my foundation might be great as well, because I thought the foundation would be great as well because like I said, so many people spoke about it, but I'm not a very big fan. I know a lot of people love it, but honestly, it's so cakey and heavy. I feel I posted a review on this and people were like, you know, you are supposed to use this with this and then you have to combine this with this, you have to use a little bit, mix in the moisturizer, and then it gives you like a beautiful finish. And I would like to try that, but honestly, I need my foundation to work by itself because I'm not there to sit and do like 100 different steps. If I'm buying a foundation, especially for 4,000-5,000 rupees, it has to make my skin look like it is made of like a baby's ass, you know. There should be something magical in it for me to spend so much money, right? So by itself, like though it gives you like a really nice look on camera, in person it is a little bit heavy. I feel it's like a little thick foundation, which I am not a big fan of. So people did ask me to like make it a little thin in consistency with like serums or moisturizers like at all, but I don't think I have so much time to do that. I would definitely try and see, but other than that, like the finish is very average. I felt like nothing exceptional. It sits on the skin, a little cakey, little thick. So I would not personally recommend this. The shade is quite a good match though, and it does oxidize a little bit too. So once it oxidizes, it matches my skin perfectly. Next, we have the Mario Makeup by Mario Foundation. I have the shade 16C. The Rare Beauty and this one, my sister actually sent me shades which she thought would suit me. And 16C is, I think, not my shade, but 16Y or N would definitely be, because the C is a cool tone one. Though the foundation matches me, it looks a little pink on me overall when I apply it. But this foundation is also so good. It just blurs, like it just literally makes your face like a blank canvas. It smooths your skin out like nothing and nobody's business. It's like if there's silicone and there's like, or like that little jelly primers which you see, and if you just put it on, it just smooth out everything. See, this is that type. I like mixing this one and NARS together, or like this one with like a very more serum like type of thing, because it is a little on the thicker side, but it gives a beautiful finish. It definitely is a little like foundation. It is a little sticky, and once you set this makeup only, you'll feel like it is there. Until then, the foundation, you'll be like, is it working, is it not working, because it is more on that thicky sticky side of foundation, but it does blur out your skin and makes it look like flawless and beautiful. So this is also a pretty good foundation to invest in. But overall, I would still recommend the NARS and the Giorgio Armani foundation. They both like so good. And the MAC Studio, the Radiance one also, it just really gives you like such a beautiful blurred skin effect. Okay, I have one last foundation to talk about. I actually again recently posted about this one. Check out that review. This is the Inside Cosmetics Ultra Thin Second Skin Long Wear Foundation. Now, the foundation by itself works very well. Gives you a beautiful finish on the skin. It looks really nice. I have it on my skin right now. It just blurs out everything. It looks really, really nice. Again, a very skin-like finish. Not very heavy. It doesn't make you feel thick and cakey. It is on a more dewier side though, that I would say. But the shade range is shitty. This is the darkest shade. This is the darkest shade in the foundation. So if you are deeper than me, you will not find a foundation for yourself. But other than that, it works really well. If you find your shade and you want an affordable foundation, then this is a great one that I recently tried and works very well. So if you're wondering why my hair is this messy, I'm trying not to style it, you guys, and it's a little complicated situation because I don't want to put heat, but if I don't put my heat, my hair is literally very, very, very naughty. Anyways, that's about it for this video, you guys. I hope it was useful. If you want to check other foundations reviews I've made, then click on the link on the screen here or here, right here. You will get the videos, or check in the description box. I will leave the links. I will leave the links to all the products if you want to shop in the description as well. You can definitely check it out. And yeah, let me know what more products you want me to review. I would love to do it for you guys. I'm loving to sitting down and playing with makeup, getting into it again, getting my hands a little dirty. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.